Be Wealthy and Smart, episode 657.
Into a world of wealth and financial freedom without budgets, boredom, or bosses on Be Wealthy and Smart. And now, here's your host, Linda P. Jones.
Welcome to Be Wealthy and Smart. I'm Linda P. Jones, America's Wealth Mentor, empowering women and men worldwide to financial freedom. On today's show, we're going to talk about seven reasons why impeachment by the House won't impact the stock market. Well, it happened. For only the third time in history, a president was impeached. Whether you agree with that or disagree with that, that's not the purpose of this particular podcast. I'm going to stay away from the politics of this, but talk about the pure economic impact, and in particular, the impact of the stock market. And I've come up with seven reasons why I don't think this impeachment by the House is going to impact the stock market. So here's why. Number one, I've noticed on Twitter, where I monitor conversations by Americans and see what both sides are saying, I have noticed that some people are mistaken and think that the president is going to be removed from office because of the impeachment by the House. This is not correct. And the reality is that the Senate is taking over and has already stated they plan to dismiss the charges, and the president has no chance of removal. It's up to the House to bring up the charges. It's up to the Senate to actually hold the trial. But ultimately, they have already said they do not believe that the president has done anything wrong, and therefore they will vote to dismiss or acquit. So since there's no chance of removal, that means there is no change of policy for the next year. And that means that the stock market has clarity in terms of what's going to happen because they know who's going to be president and they know what his policies are economically, trade-wise, etc. And so the market doesn't have uncertainty. The market doesn't have lack of clarity. And so it can proceed forward. Number two, the stock market is already shaking off the impeachment. Although this is fresh news, and like I said, this is only the third president to ever be impeached, the market was still going up. In fact, the S&P 500 is up 33% year to date and doesn't look like it wants to stop anytime soon. In fact, I've talked about the market being in a melt-up, and my Twitter account has some more comments about that if you want to take a look. Number three, the stock market is driven by profits. And that means the profitability of individual companies that trade on the stock market are the most important thing. And there's no sense of that changing in a negative way. We've already had the tax rates for corporations lowered. Their sales and revenues may increase due to trade deals. And so there isn't really anything that's going to be negatively impacted by politics. Number four, the stock market tends to look out 3 to 6 months ahead to the next quarter's revenues and earnings. And it relies on things like interest rates remaining low, consumer confidence remaining strong, and things like that in order to have that clarity to look out 3 to 6 months. So it looks like interest rates are remaining where they are, according to the Federal Reserve, maybe even trending lower. And the consumer has shown us that they're out shopping for the holidays, spending money, and sales are looking good. Number five, the trade deals such as the USMCA and China, Part One, will lift the economy by adding jobs, by opening China's financial markets for the first time to the United States, and by adding provisions that will help bring jobs and profitability and more sales and revenues to the United States in terms of car manufacturing, for example, because under the U.S.-Mexico-Canada agreement, 75% of the cars must be built in the United States, and they must use United States steel and metals. So that's going to help our metals industry. That's going to help the car industry, provide jobs and ancillary jobs. So the trade deals are just getting underway, and that should help give a boost to the stock market. Number six, unemployment remains at an all-time low, and that's important because the consumer makes up about 70% of the economy. So when the consumer's doing well, that means the U.S. economy is going to do well. And according to Larry Kudlow, there is the possibility of a middle-class tax cut that is being discussed that would happen before the election. If that happened, that would give consumers more discretionary income and allow them to boost their spending, which ultimately would mean more sales and revenues for companies and more profitability and hence higher stock prices. And number seven, we are in the fourth year of a presidential election cycle, and the research that was done between 1928 and 2016, which is the most recent that I have, shows that the fourth year of the presidential election cycle, or the actual election year, is usually the second best performing stock market of all 4 years. The third year, that would be 2019 being the third year, is the best performing year of the presidential election cycle. So that means this year will be the best year of the 4 years, and next year, if the cycle holds true, should be the second best performing year in the cycle. And if you want to hear about why I'm bullish for 2020, listen to podcast number 648, where I talked about that topic. So those are my seven reasons why I don't think the House impeachment will impact the stock market. Number one, the president won't be removed from office. Number two, the stock market is already shrugging it off. Number three, the stock market is driven by profits and profitability. Number four, the market looks out 3 to 6 months and still has clarity. Number five, the new trade deals, the USMCA and Part One with China, are going to lift the economy by adding jobs and opening financial markets and revolutionizing the car manufacturing in the U.S., among other things. Number six, unemployment is at an all-time low and the consumer is 70% of the economy, with a booster of a possible tax cut happening for the middle class. And number seven, the presidential election cycle. This year, 2019, being the best performing year of the cycle, and next year, 2020, being the second best performing year of the cycle. So for all of those reasons, I don't think that this impeachment by the House is going to have major repercussions on the stock market. And the fact that interest rates remain uncharacteristically low and there's not a lot of competition in terms of where to put money other than in the stock market, a lot of money is funneling its way into U.S. companies. If you haven't yet subscribed to Be Wealthy and Smart, hit the subscribe button and you'll be notified and won't ever miss a podcast. And don't forget, we still have our holiday review contest going where you can win some of 20 prizes that are up for grabs, and your chances of winning are tremendous. Here are some of the prizes you could win. You could win one of my Wealthy Mindset Blueprint audio sets valued at $197. You could win the Wealth Heiress book personalized by me and signed by me. That book was voted one of the best wealth books of all time by Book Authority. And you could win a wealth mentoring session with me. If you leave a podcast review, your name is entered into the drawing one time. If you leave a book review on Amazon for the Wealth Heiress book, your name will be entered into the drawing two times. And winners will be announced on the first podcast in January. And thank you to everyone who has already written reviews, book reviews, podcast reviews. You guys are amazing. I'm going to be sharing those soon on an upcoming podcast. So again, chances are really good for you to win something. That's all for today. Until next time, live the good life and be wealthy and smart.
Thank you for listening to Be Wealthy and Smart with Linda P. Jones. Share the wealth and tell your family and friends about the show. Check out our website, blog, and social media for more riches at www.bewealthyandsmart.com.